All right, we're going to get cooking on this continuity problem, which is the only problem we have. The practice of which enables us to be able to see the self-deception that we have employed upon ourselves. And self-deception it is indeed. So we are going to start out and we will insist with our will. It's an insistence with our will. Not an asking, a begging, a, you know, submissive thing. We're saying, no, I do not have a form problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. I have no other problem. The form problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Be very determined and assertive about this. So it's being willfully assertive about these continuity practice. I do not have a definition problem. I have never had a definition problem. I never will have a definition problem. The only problem I have is a continuity problem. That's it. The definition problem has absolutely no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a delineation problem whatsoever. None. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. The delineation problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. That's it. Nothing else has value. I do not have a valuing problem. I have a continuity problem. The valuing problem has no value for me whatsoever. Never will. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value. I do not have a cherishing problem. I have a continuity problem. A continuity problem is the only problem I have. The cherishing problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a neediness problem. I have never had a neediness problem. I've always had just a continuity problem. The neediness problem has absolutely no value to me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. There is no other value for me whatsoever. None. I do not have a desire problem. I have a continuity problem. The desire problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have an emergency problem. I have a continuity problem. The emergency problem holds no value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value. I do not have an oncoming problem. And I never will have an oncoming problem. I have a continuity problem, and that is the only problem that I have or ever will have is a continuity problem. The oncoming problem holds no value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. Nothing else holds any value. I do not have a developing problem whatsoever. I have one problem only, and that's the continuity problem. There is no other problem for me. The developing problem has zero value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds any value for me. It holds value for me because it resolves the one and only problem I have, which is the continuity problem. I do not have a responsiveness problem at all. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I have no other problem. The responsiveness problem holds absolutely no value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me because it resolves the continuity problem. I do not and never have had and never will have a relatedness problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. The relatedness problem has zero value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. I do not have a choice problem. I've never had a choice problem, never will have a choice problem. I only have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. The choice problem holds no value at all for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. I do not have an abandonment problem. I only have a continuity problem. The abandonment problem doesn't have any value for me whatsoever. None. Zero. Nada. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me, because only the vision of oneness resolves my one and only problem, which is the continuity problem. I do not have a severe problem. Do not have a severe problem. I have a continuity problem. The severe problem doesn't hold any value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. I do not have a giant problem. I have a continuity problem, a very severe continuity problem, but it's the only problem I have. The giant problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an all-encompassing problem. I have a severe continuity problem, yes. The all-encompassing problem doesn't hold the slightest bit of value for me. The vision of oneness does hold tremendous value for me. It's the only value there is for me, because it resolves the one and only problem I have, the continuity problem. I do not have a constricting problem. I do not have a constricting problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. The constricting problem doesn't have any value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a limiting problem. I have a continuity problem. The limiting problem doesn't hold any value whatsoever for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. I do not have an engrossing problem. I am not engrossed in any problem. I do not have an engrossing problem whatsoever. I have a severe continuity problem. The engrossing problem has no value for me. Only, without any exception, only the vision of oneness has value for me. There is no other value for me whatsoever. None. I do not have a pathetic problem. I have a continuity problem. The pathetic problem doesn't have any value whatsoever for me. The vision of oneness, and only the vision of oneness, holds value for me, because it resolves my one and only problem, the continuity problem. I do not have a ridiculous problem. I do have a continuity problem. The ridiculous problem has zero value for me. Never will have any value for me. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. Nothing else holds any value, because it solves the one and only problem that I do have, which is the severe continuity problem. So, this is how we practice. We practice with fire, with intensity, with determination, with will, with assertion, focused intensity. Focused intensity. We are stating the truth, unequivocally stating the truth. That is how we practice a continuity practice. And there's no room for any other thoughts or no's or discussion or argument or disputation or nothing. No, we are standing firm. We are standing on truth, because this is the truth. We literally don't have any other problem other than the continuity problem. There isn't any other problem. Never has been. It's our belief that there has been all these other problems which has given rise to the continuity problem. Because out of long, long habit and familiarity, we've been in a state of fear, unhappiness. And now to set this unhappiness down, which is causeless actually, is an illusion, is no cause for it at all. There's nothing except our own desire that we be fearful. We're choosing to be fearful. See, there's no choice, no cause other than our own choice, and that's always free. So it's not a problem. But when we're so used to this fear, we're afraid to choose differently. And that's a continuity problem. That is a continuity problem. We're afraid to exercise our free choice. And that's called the continuity problem. It's the only problem we have. The vision of oneness completely resolves the continuity problem. Completely resolves the continuity problem for us. Just take this on faith until you experience it. When you experience it, you will know for sure that this is what I really want. That no more fear. I can see that there's just one eternal life, all one eternal life. There's nothing to fear about experiencing this whatsoever. And then you'll realize, ah, that is the solution to the continuity problem. But if you haven't had it, take it on faith, take it on faith, take it on faith. Take it on your intuitive knowing. Just, yeah, definitely. When I see the vision of just one eternal life, everything equally supported, equally within that one eternal life, I will know there's no possibility. There is no abyss. There is no abyss. There's nothing to fear. There's nothing to fear. Okay, very great. That's it for this continuity practice.